Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, we will do stuff with money. We'll edit them in a custom delegate. Money means currency, euro sign or dollar sign, and an amount, 100. The question is, how do the delegate get its hand on an instance of our money class, which is what the model is talking about when it thinks about money? That's what we'll investigate in this episode. Okay, let's start out looking at the user interface. I have a list view here. It has three money instances in it, three amounts, you would say. And I can double click on one of these to edit it. The editing is done using a combo box for the currency, dollar and euro, and the actual amount is just the regular double spin box. Now we change the amount to 969 instead. I'll walk you through the source code and show you the most important things, but I won't bother you with all the tiny little details. So do go to this GitHub repository here and get your own copy of this code. As everything else, it starts in main. I create an instance of a list view. Please ignore this line here. I'll get back to that, trust me. I create a list view. I set a model to be an instance of my model. I set an item delegate to be an instance of my money delegate. That's the one that actually brings up the editor. My model, let's go and have a look at that. It's off the mill, a regular model. The only thing to notice here is that my data is stored in a vector of money instances. Money looks like this. Pretty straightforward implementation. The one that I have in my production code is, of course, much more complex, can compare different sets of money and so on, and many more currencies. But in this example, I just have euro and US dollar. I have a default constructor, which is required for putting stuff into a Q variant. We'll see that in just a second. I have the constructor that actually stores or takes the currency and the amount. And I have getter method. I have some instance variables here to be able to go into a Q variant, Q declare meta type money. And finally, I have a method for converting to a string. That is, of course, needed whenever I show it in my list view. Wait, what? What did you say about Q variant? Well, Q variant is this container that you can stuff anything in. And the mod view framework, that is the return type of the data method. I will return my money instances from the data method. Let me show you. So what we're looking at now is my model again. It's the data method. That's the one that will return you the data for given row, given cell in your model. It takes an index and a role. We've seen that many times before. I do some check on whether the index is valid or not. And then I go to my data structure and simply ask for the money amount at this given index. And of course, I should have been a bit more careful with testing that I'm not out of bounds. Just imagine a broken proxy model sitting on top of me. We can have another video with more details on that. I get my instance of the money here. And then I check if it's a display row, then simply return that instance. And I return it not as a string, but as the instance of a Q variant with my money inside it. Come on, Jesper, you're confusing me. You're returning a Q variant that wraps the money instance. But how does the list view know how to display that as a string? Because in the list view, it just says euro 100. It doesn't, how does it do that? Well, that is the magic line 34 I didn't tell you about. What this one says is that whenever you want to convert a money instance to a string, you can go and call toString, so money instance toString, and that will get your string. That's the trick that list view does. Rumors has it that this facility will go away in Qt 6. So if you want to be absolutely sure, just ignore this one here, nuke the line like this, and then go to your model. And in addition to the display model, also a display role, also add an edit role. So I would go return and what's called, it's called money.toString. So if you are asking for display, just return the string. Otherwise, if you are asking for the edit row, then return this. And just observe, I'm just running it for you now, observe how it still displays correctly. It won't work anymore, so I'll show you how to crash my application here. Well, didn't crash, but it didn't really edit the right amount because I'm asking for the display row in my delegate. So let's just go to the delegate right away and see how it gets its data. My money delegate over here is a regular instance of a regular subclass of QStyle item delegate. And the actually getting value, I simply go to my set editor data, I go index.data, and now I need to actually ask for the edit role instead of my display role. And I need to, when I set the data back, that works well. Of course, I don't actually check for the role in my set data. Now you'll notice that it says Euro 200. I'll leave it to you to read all of the source code of the delegate. But the key thing here is that the delegate actually get its hand on an instance of the money class. And when it's done editing, it creates another instance of the money class and call the set data on the model with that instance. And let's see what that looks like. The set data is right in this set model data, which is what the view calls on the delegate whenever it wants to tell the delegate to save the data back to the model. Model, set data, and here I create an instance. I go to my money editor. You can look at that. It's super trivial, just a combo box and a line edit, a double spin box next to each other. Go to that editor and call value. That returns, as you can see here, it returns an instance of the money class again. I cast that I wrap that money class into a Q variant, and I call set data on my model. In my model, the set data method gets the value in. See, I didn't test for the role. That was why it wasn't a problem with saving for display versus edit role. I could have, of course, but I get the money in here and I just convert that amount and I save that into my data storage. As the comment says here, again, this is not bulletproof code. So if you write this yourself, be more careful. Always, when you work with model view, think of that upstairs, what you usually is a view, that could all of a sudden be a proxy model that queries things wrong, and better safe than sorry, better have a warning than a crash in that situation. That's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. I hope you enjoyed it. Do go and download the source code. And if you create a new editor that looks much better than mine for editing amounts, please send it to me. I would love to have that in my own production code. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. I hope to see you next time. And do remember, thumbs up if you like this. Until next time, have a great day.